Hey everybody, Krystal Gamer here with a brand new episode of Rags to Riches, starring Katerina Loverly, our once homeless and frumpy girl who at one time had nothing but the clothes on her back and even stole food and lived on park benches, but who is now a hot and sexy and talented rising star, a three-star celebrity musician who's quickly moving to four stars, is known for her good reputation and generosity, and has recently landed a contract with the best recording label in the land. She's got a load of tracks released now that are making her a boatload of money. Add to that her licensed violin, guitar, and keyboard songs, and her royalty checks are quite impressive. The last one coming in at over $6,700. And since we last saw her, she's released two new tracks, Prince Doggy Doo Doo and Prince Kitty Mew Mew, both of which seem to have landed her a lot more money. But there's even bigger news. Katerina decided to take the plunge and buy the pond house. So there's been a lot of time spent moving her in. She took her own furniture and belongings, of course. And she decided to make some renovations to the place to better suit her needs. Instead of having an ensuite and a half bath, she decided it would make more sense to create one single bathroom so that she could have more bedroom space. She also expanded the back room a little bit and converted it to her music room. Finally, she put a small addition on to the back of the house for her recording studio. The only problem she found so far is that she's had to put a fence up, which is not something she really wanted to do, as she loves the surrounding area. She would have preferred to leave her backyard wide open to the views and all that. But unfortunately, there's this persistent paparazzi problem that she has to deal with. And these folks have no qualms about coming right onto her property and invading her personal space. So a fence was her best solution. Last but certainly not least, she didn't want to give up her adorable little hanging swing that used to sit on the front porch of her old place. And this house had no real good place for that, so she decided to make a place for it. She had a small gazebo built in the backyard specifically for the swing. It faces the pond and the nature beyond, and she feels it's very quaint and cute and all that, and so she's very happy with it. She also managed to incorporate her garden into the backyard as well. So life is good. The house is good. She's loving it. She misses her old place for sure. She misses the island. She misses her old house for sure. But so far, she's pretty happy with this place. And so one of her first orders of business after all of the construction was done and all of that was to take Treasure on a jog around the neighborhood, get the lay of the land, see what's what, see kind of what the whole place just looks like. And so it turns out she's very, very close to that bar called the Screeching Llama that she visited a couple of times recently. And so she's very happy about that. The bar isn't, it's not a posh bar. It's a more rural hometown type bar. And she really likes the feel of the place. And other than that, she's near a few houses that dot the area and a pretty waterfall. And she also spotted at least one or two potential fishing holes besides her own personal pond that she has now, of course. And there's a little park that looks cute with its benches and its barbecue and all that. So it seems to be a pretty nice area. It's not her island, but it is a pretty nice area. And so just a little while after she and Treasure got back, she was surprised by the neighborhood welcome wagon. Not one, not two, but three men showed up at her front door to welcome her to the neighborhood. And so after some introductions on the porch, she invited them all in. And if you're thinking that at least one of these guys looks really familiar, you'd be right. Yes, the crazy handsome dude is Sterling Gardner, the same Sterling Gardner that she met and instantly liked at the Screeching Llama not long ago. So it turns out that the really nice farmhouse that she saw down the road belongs to him. So, oh, happy day. So the other guy is Darius. He seems like a nice guy, though a bit shabby looking. His clothes are kind of ratty and whatnot. But still, it seems pretty nice. And apparently he's a dog nut who wants to be a vet one day. And he lives in the small house on the really beautiful lot. And he's the one with all the doggy agility equipment outside. So she thought that they'd get along well. And she told him that she was interested in meeting his dogs one day soon, too. Then there was the third guy, Kyle. And Katerina had seen him on TV before on some commercial or other, but she couldn't remember for what. She just knew he was some low-level actor, and he seemed a little bit antisocial until she invited everyone over to eat. But then he did join in then, so that was good. And it was fortunate as hell that Katerina had just made some chips and salsa right before the guys came over. So the four of them had some good conversation over the meal, and then the guys took off. And Sterling did say that he was looking forward to seeing her again, so she thought that was promising. And she was hoping that it would be sooner rather than later. So after they all left, she was kind of reeling from the whole thing. And so she just went out back to play her violin for a bit and just, you know, kind of chill. And of course, she was thinking about Sterling pretty much the entire time she was playing. And Sterling, for his part, jogged back home, not even believing he was just in Katerina Loverly's house and that she lived practically right next door. And he couldn't help but wonder if he had any chance at her at all. I mean, he loved her music and he was a big fan of hers before even meeting her. But now, after hanging with her at her place today, he knew he was totally, totally into her. So during the jog, he was just reviewing everything he knew about her so far. And so, you know, he thought to himself, okay, not only is her music amazing, but her cooking is great. She likes to fish so much that she bought a house specifically for the fishing pond out back. She loves dogs, loves to jog with her dog, enjoys hiking and gardening and all things outdoors, just like I do. Plus, she's hot as hell. He thought he had to be dreaming. Like, this could not be reality. No way. So he went home and he went straight to his weight machine and started lifting. He had so much energy and his mind was racing and he needed to do something active and just think about her and fantasize about her. And so he just kept wondering if he had any chance, contemplating if he should ask her out or not. He felt like she was so real and so down to earth and so natural and almost completely oblivious to her own fame, actually. He remembered her talking about having to put up a fence around the house because the paparazzi invading her space and all. But other than seeming a bit annoyed, and rightfully so, at the violations of her privacy, the fame seemed to have almost no effect on her. So he just stayed lost in thoughts of her for hours as he worked out. Then Darius went home to hang out with his dogs, but he was thinking about her a bit as well. He couldn't believe he'd met a star. I mean, it's not every day that you meet a big star and find out that she lives practically next door to you. And he also couldn't believe that she was just as hot in person as she was on her album covers. And, you know, of course, like any guy, he started thinking about, you know, what it would be like to have a girl like her. It would be so amazing. But he knew he wasn't going to find out. Number one, she was a star and a pretty big star at that. And number two, he saw the way she was looking at Sterling the whole time they were there today. So he knew she's totally into that dude. He's got no chance. But she likes dogs a lot. And so he thought that maybe they might at least be able to be friends, and being friends with a big star, well, you know, who can complain about that, right? And then Kyle went home and did Kyle, which is to say he thought mostly about himself. He was happy with himself that he did the polite neighborly thing that his manager told him he was supposed to do. And according to his manager, Katerina was at a level that he should get to know. So he did what he was told to do. But he felt like he lowered himself sitting at the same table as that Darius dude. Where the hell did that dude get his clothes anyway? The thrift store? Kyle would never. And his thoughts on Sterling were kind of along the lines of, yeah, whatever. That dude spends too much time at the gym. And Kyle also mistakenly thought he was too good for Katerina, but, you know. So Kyle did Kyle. But back at the ranch, Katerina was still reeling hours later. She could barely sleep that night. She could barely eat. She was trying to keep herself occupied, but her mind kept going to Sterling over and over again. And she kept imagining him kissing her over and over again. So she started thinking maybe she'd take Treasure for a jog again, you know, by Sterling's house, and maybe he might be outside and they could quote-unquote, accidentally run into each other. So she tried that. It didn't work. Didn't see him going or coming back, unfortunately. That left her a bit bummed, but they lived so close to each other now, and it's not like she didn't jog regularly on purpose to stay in shape anyway, and for treasure too. Plus, there's always the screeching llama right down the street. And so she figured that they were going to run into each other again either way. Now, little did she know that as she was jogging by, Sterling was in his gym working out while trying to work up the courage to ask her out. And it takes a lot of damn working out to get up the guts to ask out a 4-star celebrity with a pristine reputation on a date. And yes, you heard that right. During this short time period, Katerina relicensed one of her guitar songs, Katerina's Morning. Plus, she released a new track called Dwarvian Plushy Burglarizing Bandits. Oh, and she made a $1,000 donation to a local charity, too. So it would seem that those few feats put her over the edge because she's now a 4-star celebrity, otherwise known as a proper celebrity. And it tells us the walk, the talk, the look. Katerina's a proper celebrity. The general public now considers it a big deal to catch a glimpse of her out on the street. Didn't they already? Kind of seemed like they did already to me. But anyway, it says when she's amongst her adoring fans, she can incite cheers to really kick the crowd into a frenzy. And she's also got the appearance of being a public figure nailed. Why, she's literally a shining star, and she's got the new walk style that only a celebrity could pull off. Both of these can be adjusted by clicking on Katerina, which they have been adjusted because Katerina is not the type to do the celebrity walk and to glow and all of that. It's just not her. Katerina is a down-to-earth girl. She is not letting the stardom thing go to her head. So that's that part of it. And she is also a complete angel, and it says that Katerina is a shining beacon of positivity for the community. Passing by other Sims will elicit friendly waves and cheerful smiles as everyone's day is brightened by her presence. Friends will be more forgiving if she commits any social miscues, and they won't be quick to judge her. That part is really good, because Katerina sometimes has some issues with conversations ending up uncomfortable and awkward, and I don't know what happens to her, but she has some things. So that is super good for her. And then, finally, Katerina has earned the credibility to host her very own charity benefit parties, gather other do-gooders together for a fun time while contributing towards excellent causes. And so, yeah, this is a big day. She is now a 4-star celebrity with a pristine reputation. This is quite a thing. She's picked up this established name thing, so like they weren't recognizing her already. But now when she sells, publishes, or licenses something that took skill to create, she'll earn more money and increased royalties. Now, I can't imagine how much higher she can go because her checks are typically anywhere between $5,000 on up. The last one was almost $7,000. So I can't wait to see where her royalty checks go from here. This is going to be awesome. And this one here is the rally thing. So she can give inspirational speeches to boost skill games of nearby Sims. And it means that she provides her great reputation, means other Sims trust her to provide worldly advice. So she can do these speeches and talk about her secrets to success, and the Sims will all listen, and they'll get some increased skill afterwards, which is pretty cool. And she gets a few hours of extra social success with others. So that seems pretty nice as well. It has been a very big episode for Katerina. She got her new house here, so she has her new place to live. She's got a fishing pond in the backyard. She had the guys over, met Sterling Gardner again, spent some time with him. That was good. Got the lay of the land, jogging and checking out the area. And plus, she has made a 4-star celebrity and has a pristine reputation. So today has just been gangbusters. And I don't know about you guys, but I can't wait to see if Sterling Gardner actually gets the courage to call her and ask her on a date, or if they just run into each other, or what's going to happen, because I think that we can be pretty certain that something's going to happen there. So I'm looking forward to next time. I hope you guys are, and I hope that you enjoyed this episode. If you did, please do hit the like button, comment, share, subscribe. All that good stuff helps us YouTubers out a ton. And thanks for spending the time with me today. Hope to see y'all back again next time. Bye now.